Good morning, students. Yesterday we started new lesson fiber to fabric, and yesterday we discussed about the fibers and types of fibers, the synthetic fibers and natural fibers. In natural fibers, again there are two types, that is the animal fibers and plant fiber. Okay. So in this lesson, fiber to fabric, we are going to do detailed study about the animal fibers. Now, what is the animal fibers? Fibers which we are getting from the animals are known as animal fibers. So here two example, wool and silk. Wool and silk we are getting from animals, so they are known as the animal fibers. So in this lesson we are going to see the detailed study about the wool and silk. So today first we will start wool. Okay, as you know that wool, when we are using the woolen clothes, mostly in winter season we are wearing woolen clothes. What is the reason behind this? Why we are wearing woolen clothes in winter season? Why? To keep our body warm. Okay, so we are wearing the woolen clothes. But why we choose the woolen fiber only? Because there is one reason. Okay, then what is the reason? See, wool, and wool we are getting from the sheep. Okay, so wool trap air, and this air is wool trap air. Okay, and air is a bad conductor of heat. Air is bad conductor of heat. So it does not allow to exit heat outside. Okay, so whatever the our body heat, it remains as it is in a wool. Why? Because wool trap air, and air characteristic is what? It is a bad conductor of heat, so it is not allowed to pass heat outside. It keeps warm, and because of that we are wearing woolen clothes in winter season. Okay, why? Because in winter season we need the warm legs, our body need warm, so we are wearing woolen clothes. So because of that, to prepare the woolen clothes, means sweaters, socks, okay, for that we need wool. And wool, commonly you all know that wool we are getting from sheep. Okay, so sheep is not only one animal that wool we are getting only from the sheep. There are many animals, those are giving us a wool. Okay, camel is there, rabbit is there, then goat is there. Okay, so many different animals, mostly those are found in hilly areas, they are giving us wool. So in this lesson, first we will see only about the sheep. What is a sheep? How we are getting the wool? Before to start that, first we will see that, see the body of these animals. These animals means which animals? Sheep, camel, goat, rabbit. Okay, the body of these animals covered by thick coat of hair called fleece. Means they are having the thick coat of hair. Now why they are having the thick coat of hair? Mostly these all animals are found in hilly areas, and hilly areas there is a temperature is very less, so they are having the thick coat of fur. she is taking a care, she is giving you on time food, okay, she is taking care. The same thing, rearing of sheep means what? To look after the sheep by giving them food, shelter and health care. Means how our mother is taking care of us, the same way shepherds. See, shepherd is a new word for you. What is the shepherds? Those are taking care of the sheep, are known as a shepherd. They look after the sheep by giving them food, shelter and health. They are known as a shepherd. Okay, so rearing of sheep means they are taking the care of sheep, they are giving food on time, they are cleaning them properly, okay, they are providing shelter to them, then health care. So everything they see means they are taking the care of sheep. Those are taking care, that particular person are known as a shepherd. See, in this word only means this, if you will see the word, you will immediately get the idea why they are known as a shepherd. Shepherd means those are taking the care of sheep. Okay, now one more point is there, that is the selective breeding. See, here we see the two types of fleece. Fleece means what? Hair, that is the soft hair and coarse breed hair. Breed means what? It is very rough hair. So if you want the good quality of wool, the term is related to that, that is the selective breeding. If you want the good quality of wool, means we want the soft wool, the selective breeding is one term. Now selective breeding means what? Here we have to select, means that particular person, they are selecting the parents. See, two individuals having desirable characteristics are selected as a parent. Selective breeding means what? Those are having the good quality fur, that we are selecting as a parents. Means two individuals we are selecting, those are having good quality of fur, and when they give the birth to the new young one, that we will get the good quality of fur and it is a more amount of fur in that. Okay, so that process means selecting parents. Selective breeding means what? Selecting parents are known as a selective breeding. Two individuals having desirable characteristics are selected as a parents. This process is known as a selective breeding. Okay, so what we discussed today, we started the animal fibers, and that first one, wool, and why we are wearing the woolen clothes only in the winter season, that I explained you. Okay, then a fleece means thick coat of hair are known as a fleece. There are two types of fleece. One is a soft under hair close to the skin, and second one is a coarse breed hair. Okay, the next point we learn, that is the rearing of sheep. Rearing of sheep means taking care of sheep. Rearing of sheep means to look after the sheep by giving them food, shelter and health care, etc. And those are taking this care, those are caring them, that particular person are known as a shepherd. And selective breeding means if you want the good quality of wool, we are only selecting the two parents, and that two parents, they are giving the birth to the new young one, and that new young one, we are getting the good characteristic, means good quality of wool. This process is